guys, it's your girl Miss Annie J, and I am back with another video on PMDD, going to be discussing how I will be tackling the condition in 2024. If you are new to my channel or you have never heard of PMDD, it is the acronym for premenstrual dysphoric disorder, and it is the severe and debilitating and traumatic version of PMS. PMS times 1000. It is a very, very difficult condition to live with. So before I get into how I'm going to deal with this condition, I just want to go through a few little finer details. As we all know, PMDD has some very catastrophic emotional symptoms that we deal with, and those tend to be the symptoms of PMDD that really do slow our lives down, put us in a position where we feel like we're not able to be consistent with things, our relationships are affected, work is affected, like it literally can be debilitating. Aside all of the emotional symptoms that I've covered in the past, sadness, depression, anxiety, suicidal thoughts, PMDD also comes with physical symptoms, which I haven't typically focused on in my previous videos. Some of the physical symptoms that I personally experience with PMDD include food cravings, severe fatigue, weight gain, disturbed digestive function, i.e. constipation, inflamed eczema, and insomnia. It is a batch of different things, guys. Overall, it is not pleasant. Now, aside all of these things that I've mentioned in terms of the symptoms, I know that we experience immediate relief when we have the onset of our bleed. However, if you're anything like me, I now experience excruciating physical pain when my period starts. When I really think about it, I go through 3/4 of the month experiencing hormonal upheaval of emotion and physical changes. That is a lot for anybody to be dealing with. Now, you're probably wondering, how am I able to manage such difficult condition and still be able to live my life, do my YouTube, go to work, and manage and sustain the relationships that I have? Basically, all the odds just seem to be against me, right? But what did I learn in 2023 that is now going to help me move forward for 2024 and the years to come? Increasing your feel-good factor. That is my secret weapon now for me to sustain and deal with the condition and to sustain my life and to move forward with life as normal. Increasing my feel-good factor is monumentally key. I increase my feel-good factor in the most productive ways possible. This minimizes the effect of the symptoms that I experience, which then enables me to continue with life as best as possible. The negative symptoms that I am experiencing at the time, they start to diminish and my feel-good factor takes over. The symptoms that I would typically be subjected to and I feel like, oh, life is a drag, I don't experience that because I am feeling so good within myself, and it actually outweighs the heaviness of the PMDD symptoms that I go through, both physical and emotional. Now, how do I personally increase my feel-good factor? By spending a lot of time on my self-development, reading knowledgeable books, listening to motivational speakers, spending more time around the people that I love, looking after my physical health by going to the gym regularly, eating a very nutritious and balanced diet. I also spend more time on my hobbies, i.e. YouTube, and I always ensure that I'm able to take some time out to relax. Now, the reason for me why doing these things which benefit my feel-good factor are so important is because subconsciously I end up creating a routine for my life. When I have this routine going that involves all of these positive factors that improve my well-being, I'm able to consistently work on the things that I do without allowing the negative symptoms of PMDD to affect me, because my mind is not focused on the PMDD. It actually lessens the effects and the impact that it may possibly have had on my outside factors. Now, not forgetting other things that I have previously been through with you guys in the past, i.e. castor oil, turmeric water, the physical things that we can do to help deal with the symptoms of PMDD. When you are combining everything together, guys, trust me, the past 3 years, possibly going on 4, I have not experienced PMDD to the level that I used to experience it in the past. You guys have seen me post that video where I was sat in the car, I was emotional, I was crying, I felt like life was over, I had no hope, I had no sense of self-worth, was suffering from body dysmorphia. I was depressed. I was anxious. That is what my life used to be before I started to implement the things that I share and talk to you guys about. I do not like to talk about anything on my YouTube channel that I do not do myself. Everything that I talk about, the advice that I give, even the tutorials that I do, it's things that I have tested and tried myself. If there is things that I can share that have worked for me and I am on the incline in life, then I definitely want to share that with other women who deal with this condition, because I know that you can feel like you are in a very, very lonely place. Take it from me, increasing your feel-good factor, increasing endorphins any way that you can, whatever it is that you are interested in, your hobbies, take them seriously, because the more you feel fulfilled in yourself, happy, you're joyful, you feel content with life. When the condition begins, it's not going to impact you in the same way it would if you are doing absolutely nothing, because it is tough. It can cause women to sabotaging relationships, sabotaging career aspirations, studies. It is difficult. So if you want to see change, if you keep doing the same thing and change is not coming, it is time to switch it up. If you want to see improvement in the way you're able to deal with and manage this condition, the change has to start with you. Ladies, take it from me, because I have been living with PMDD for over a decade, and it is not going to get any easier until we get to a point where we reach menopause, and that is like mid-ages. What am I saying here? Later in life, we cannot be sustaining and dealing with life, always going through the up, the down. Guys, it's traumatic. It's traumatic to have a good 2 weeks and then to have a bad 2 weeks and then to do it all again consistently every month. That experience is traumatic, because you feel like you're doing well, things are fine, etc. And then all of a sudden you have a huge dip in how you feel. Emotions just go all the way to the left. You go from being this happy, bubbly, cheery person, and all of a sudden you are so deeply depressed. You're so fatigued. You're sad. You hate everything about yourself. You don't like the way your hair is anymore. You don't like your body stature. You're unhappy with the clothes that you have. PMDD is catastrophic. And so it is going to take catastrophic pushback to be able to overcome the symptoms of the condition, because it's going to keep happening month on month. You do not want it to take hold of and ruin your life. Trust me, I have been there. This is the whole reason why I started my YouTube channel, primarily because I wanted to reach out and help other women that deal with this condition, speaking from somebody who goes through it themselves. Guys, life has been on an incline for me for some years now, and I am determined for it to never stop. I am determined for that incline to continue, because I will not allow this condition to get me back to the place that it used to have me, where I could barely deal with life itself. And that is all I want for you. I want you guys to be in a better place. I want you to feel improved in yourself. I want you to experience life with joy and feel fulfilled, and it can be done. Get working on your feel good factors, the things that make you happy. Start to look after yourself. Invest in a gym membership, or go to the park and start running a couple of times a week, or go walking. Start taking your hobbies more seriously and invest in them. If you're interested in a certain niche or field, invest in it. Take a course. Guys, invest in you and increase your endorphins, and the effects of PMDD will become minimized. You will start to notice it less and less. It's not going to take over your life the way it has been, as you pursue the things that make you happy, the things that bring joy to your life, the social circles that you have that bring fulfillment. Do something about it today. So join me, start increasing your feel-good factor, and let me know how it's going for you. I am nobody special. If the things that I am doing work for me, it just shows me that it can also work for you too. So be encouraged. This condition is not going to make your life meaningless. You can make your life meaningful. You just have to get up and start doing things. And if you haven't seen my other PMDD videos, other things that I do to deal with particular symptoms, check those out. Things used to be dire for me. I used to be a horrible spender because of irrational spending based on how I was feeling because of the symptoms of PMDD. I thought those things would help me feel better. I went about it all the wrong way. And my experiences, I do not want you guys to go through. So definitely check out my PMDD playlist. That can also help you to improve your life. Ladies, that is it from your girl, Miss Annie J. Until I do my next PMDD video, keep your head up. Keep believing in yourself and know that this condition does not make you who you are. This condition does not invalidate your life. You are worth everything and you just need to start believing that and acting on it. Please, ladies, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. And until my next video on PMDD, make sure that you continue to take care of yourselves. It's your girl, Miss Annie J. Bye.
See the new girl vibe, she in her stride. She goes side to side, she goes tap, 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 tap.